First, Carrie Prejean. Now, Ariana Afsar. It seems that simply being Miss California means you have controversial views on hot-button issues. Just 4 days after being crowned, the new Miss California came on this very station, KNBC Digital Channel 4.2, and was asked if illegal immigrants should be given an opportunity for amnesty.
I don't believe that amnesty should be granted just because I think that people who want to see a United States citizen need to come over here legally in order to get the privileges that every American receives.
If you missed that, she said, I don't believe amnesty should be granted. I think people who want to be a United States citizen need to come over here legally in order to get the privileges that every American receives. Afsar herself, who was recently a contestant on American Idol, is the daughter of an immigrant from Bangladesh. But the UCLA sophomore says that just being in this country shouldn't mean you're given the rights of legal citizens. Our contributors tonight, Megan Barth and Leo Terrell, our pictures are furnished by Skype. Leo, I'm going to start with you. Is she right? Is she wrong? And what is with our pageant winners and their political stands?
Well, first of all, she won't win Miss America because she just signed her death sentence. She's alienated maybe 50% of the country. People who have made a commitment to society here who are illegal aliens, should they be given amnesty? People who serve this country as illegal immigrants, should they be given amnesty? For her to sit there and just say it's a yes or no question is a bad answer. And she's alienated people. Her story is a true American success story, but I think it's a very poor answer because there's exceptions to the general rule of yes and no. She won't win Miss America because she'll alienate people.
What do you think, Megan? Is she right? Is she wrong?
I think she has every right to express her opinion, specifically if she is a first generation or an immigrant. She has the knowledge and the background and the experience of what it takes to become a legal immigrant, and she has every right to express that opinion. She doesn't alienate 50% of the population. She actually might alienate only 30 to 35% of the population since the latest poll came out that Americans up to 65% are against amnesty. So she perhaps might win the crown based on that fact, if that's really the only fact or factor that goes into her winning. Unfortunately, Miss America or Miss California has gotten extremely politicized. And if you have one of the judges that don't agree, perhaps if Leo was a judge for Miss America, he might strike her out for having that opinion. And that really
is unfortunate. History repeats itself.
That is very unfortunate.
Carrie Prejean signed a death certificate when she came out and gave a black and white answer and opposed it. And what I'm saying to you is that in beauty contests, it's going to
be a death certificate.
She lost.
70% of the voters in this state, 70% of the voters in California voted for Prop 8.
You know what? It's amazing about that because there's the federal government, which I think represents the entire country, just filed a lawsuit against the state of Arizona because of that immigration law. So I disagree. It's only 30%.
All right.
Well, that's what the latest poll says.
Okay. You know what? We're going to move on and talk about that in a bit. But I can't think we can all agree on one thing. Megan, you made the comment if Leo was a judge, he might vote her out. I think everybody here will agree Leo would love to be a judge. Is that fair to say, Leo?
Absolutely. I can't wait. Please, can I be a judge?
I'll second that.
All right, here we go. Prop 19, get used to hearing about it. The initiative to legalize and tax marijuana will be on the California ballot in November. If it passes, plenty of people will start lighting up legally and the state will get rich. Where's LA's cut? Perhaps they should follow Sacramento's lead. The Capital City Council voted last night to place their own marijuana tax on the ballot. In addition to state taxes, how about some taxes if you want to buy and smoke marijuana? Right now, it would apply to sales of medicinal marijuana, but should Prop 19 pass, they'll be ready to profit as well. Meanwhile, our city council is worried about Arizona, and they can't spot a cash cow when it's right in front of them. Berkeley's looking at doing the same thing. Sacramento is as well. So I ask this, shouldn't Los Angeles be considering this, Megan?
Well, they should, and here's the odd thing. I mean, if you look at marijuana and the use of marijuana, you know, more now than ever is marijuana being used in this state because of medical marijuana prescriptions and medical marijuana cards. Pretty much anyone can walk into a facility. If you look in the back of the OC Weekly or the LA Weekly, all you see are advertisements for doctors and places where you can pick up a medical marijuana card. So if it becomes legal for recreational use, I'm not surprised that this that other cities are going to tax it. I'm just waiting for something called the sunshine tax to come down so the federal government or the state government can actually figure out how to balance their budget instead of cutting spending. They're just looking for more tax revenues.
But here's my question.
I am surprised that LA has not put that into consideration because they love to tax and hate to cut.
Well, that's true, and they're, you know, very worried about illegal immigration in Arizona. They really don't have enough time to worry about what's going on in L.A. Leo, what do you think?
Exactly.
Well, L.A. should do it, but guess what? If this bill passed, Fred, assume the following fact. The federal government, depending on the administration, the federal government is going to probably challenge the law because you might recall during the Bush administration, they took a hard policy against medical marijuana use in California. Now, the Obama administration might look the other way, but this Prop 19, if it passed, is going to be subject to federal scrutiny because I got news for you. It's still a drug as far as the federal government is concerned. So go ahead, L.A. You might get some money for the next couple of years. But if there's a different administration with a different attitude, this law is going to be invalidated.
Well, I believe that the president has come out on record as saying he didn't think this is a very good idea. He's already made that statement.
Yeah, I think this is a law that's going to be immediately challenged in court as to whether or not the state can classify marijuana for recreational use to tax it, because I think the federal government's going to step in.
Well, I know in the latest poll, we talked about this last night, the people that want it have a slight lead over the people that don't. Now, the LAUSD is in serious trouble. We know that. They're not only in a world of hurt, they consistently rank far below national averages for education. Maybe it's because they're spending $578 million on one school. The Robert F. Kennedy Community Schools are supposed to open this fall, but they needed another $6 million, and they got it last night. It's a beautiful campus. It's on the side of the Ambassador Hotel where Robert Kennedy was assassinated. But if you break it down, the cost per student to build this thing, $135,000, 40% higher than the average school built in central L.A. Clearly, this project started before the economy turned sour. But $578 million on a school? What is the LAUSD thinking, Leo?
Fred, you know what? I am a fiscal conservative. Surprise, surprise. This is a disaster. I don't know what they're thinking. A half a billion dollars on a school is going to serve 4,200 students. There's schools that are empty. There's schools that they can use year round. This is a perfect example of why we need charter schools or school kids to go to private school. This is a boondoggle to spend $578 million on a school when we have poor teachers, we have lack of books in existing schools. This is nothing more than a shrine to the school board. It is a waste of money. I saw it the other day. It's a beautiful school, but it does not justify a half a billion dollars.
Megan, what do you think?
I love that I agree with Leo on this one. It is a shrine to the LAUSD. And the LAUSD right now, according to reports, is about $700 million in debt. They had a school board meeting 2 weeks ago, and instead of addressing their 41% graduation rate, which yields a 59% dropout rate, they chose to instead address local car wash businesses that needed to be unionized if they were to wash school district cars. So the LA Unified District has no problem telling private business owners how to operate their business while they oversee one of the largest, I believe they have the largest budget in the state. They receive 40%, all schools receive 40% of tax revenues, and they have the audacity with a 41% graduation rate to build a school and not outfit the existing schools with the tools that children need to learn and need to have in order to learn. It's an atrocity. The taxpayers should be outraged. And the contractor, I cannot find the contractor's name that's in charge of the general contractor that's in charge of building the school and provide the, sorry?
Well, I'll tell you why you can't find the contractor's name, because he's bought an island in the South Pacific where he currently
lives. You better believe it.
Isn't that funny? And sorry, one more thing. He gave a $21 million amendment to his original budget for extra, you know, things that came up. It's an outrage.
You got to have the right chandeliers in any building.
Okay. Oh, and talking benches.
Let's go.